mom, Cheryl, already getting a little emotional back home in Cincinnati?
I'm sure she is. There's been a lot of folks that come up and have conversations with her, I'm sure, about how much seeing number three playing has meant to them.
In addition to Kelsey Mitchell, Stephanie Mavunga in the starting lineup for Ohio State, averaging a double-double for the second straight year. Asia Doss, an assist-to-turnover ratio of 3.4. For Ohio State, averaging a double-double for the second straight year. Asia Doss, an assist-to-turnover ratio of 3.421. For the Bearcats, who have won three of their last four games, Nakira Goings leading them in scoring right now, coming off a career-high 25 last time out, a win against Howard. Four are in double figures for Cincinnati. We are ready to go here at St. Ursula Academy. Joe Vasili, Jules Gallion, Nakisha Thompson, our officiating crew. 1,000... I'd say plus packed in here in Cincinnati. Opening tip won by Ohio State. They are the road team, but they are in white. Cincinnati wearing home black today, and Mitchell wasting no time to get on the board.
The offense you'll see from Ohio State most times, shots up in less than 11 seconds, and the quick response for the Bearcats.
Angel Reiser averaging 7.5 points a game, was 5 for 5 from the field against Howard. How about Cincinnati coming out and running with an Ohio State team that loves to run?
Love it. You match energy with energy. You want to start us off at 150 miles, we're ready to go.
And a turnover for Ohio State Bearcats basketball. There is Kevin McGuff, head coach, in his fifth season, a homecoming for him. It's also a special homecoming for someone else in this building who happens to be standing next to me that we'll get to in a few minutes, as well as Goings loses it out of bounds, and it'll be Ohio State basketball. Jamel Elliott is in her ninth season as Cincinnati's head coach. 101 victories last time out. It was a victory over Howard, 87-53. Cincinnati never trailed in that game.
They really needed that offensive output coming into this one. A rare air ball miss from Kelsey Mitchell.
Grabbed by Goings.
Sometimes you got to get them out of your system. Yeah, I usually average one a game, and I felt better, honestly, after I shoot an air ball. I'm like, okay.
I don't think your coaches felt better about that, though.
They knew it came with the package.
Foul called on the drive to the basket on Mavunga. This is a very tight rotation for Ohio State, so they have to defend without fouling, and we've seen how it's all centered around this season with Kelsey Mitchell, not the only one in her last year of eligibility for Ohio State.
The success of the Buckeyes, to me, is dictated by their defense this year. They're so proficient at scoring, but defense is what separates the good from the great teams, and certainly the great from the elite.
Harper with the rebound. Mitchell, that's
great
what Brooke
dish.
Was talking about, getting her teammates involved, but Mavunga couldn't finish it.
Good job by Cincinnati, not fouling that play.
Feed on the inside for two.
Yeah, Goings and Reiser working well together early in this first quarter. Just love the way Jamel Elliott's team has started this game. They're in a 3-2 zone.
That three-pointer is rebounded by Goings. Kira Goings, a junior from Marietta, Georgia. Shanice Johnson trying to find Sam Rogers on the back door, but lost out of bounds. Ohio State ball. It's all about the starting five for Ohio State. Look at the minute breakdown for the five on the floor right now for the Buckeyes.
Which is exactly why they play so much, well, this year, so much zone defense. Because your legs, they got to recover somewhere.
In transition, a three knocked down by Asia Doss. First points for Doss, averaging 9.5 points a game.
Ohio State will also fall back into that 3-2 zone, and a very important early bucket for Sam Rogers. You know, Ohio State's so capable of quick runs. Make sure you take shots when you can get them.
Back and forth we go. Sierra Calhoun answers with a three of her own.
Nice way to start the game. I like it. You see Cincinnati testing the lanes with Ohio State to see if they're going to overcommit. That's why they tried to go backdoor a few plays ago. There's not enough sauce to get into Sam Rogers.
Shot clock down to 9. Johnson on the drive. A little fake to get some space for 2.
Good pull up and poise by Johnson as the shot clock's running down. You got to create on your own.
Mitchell can't get that to go, and good position on the rebound for Reiser. Reiser's really played well as of late, coming on, scoring and on the glass.
Yeah, 11 points against Howard. She also had 3 steals in that game. Her presence is so critical today. Stop Kelsey Mitchell in transition is priority number one. And A. Harper's going to get called with the walk.
Traveling violation. Game's first substitution is in. It's talented freshman Amari Thomas, an impact freshman for Jamel Elliott. Thomas averaging nearly 12 points a game, second on the team in scoring, had a season-high 19 against Howard last time out.
How about that? Double-double for the freshman all the way from Oakland, California.
And she is fouled as a couple of opportunities on the offensive glass for Cincinnati. And Thomas will go to the line.
If you're Kevin McGuff, you're a little frustrated that two of your best rebounders, Mavunga and Harper, right there to grab the rebound. And now Mavunga's got 2 fouls. Make sure you pursue the basketball, box out. That's just effort.
That will get Alexa Hart into the game. Mavunga to the bench with the 2 fouls in the first 4 minutes. Number 2 score, the number 1 rebounder for Ohio State, Stephanie Mavunga, 16 points, 12 rebounds a game on the bench for the Buckeyes. So that depth being tested in the opening moments. Harper. Sierra Calhoun with the second chance here for the Buckeyes. Mitchell. That won't drop. Rebound for Goins. Mitchell now 1 for 4 from the floor.
You see Lene Harper trying to get Sierra Calhoun's attention and say, hey, come up, let's get a quick trap and turnover.
In and out from Anna Owens. Mitchell on the push. Doss. Harper to Mitchell. Mitchell thought she was fouled. Nothing called. And running back the other way is Goins. Blocked. Strong block by Calhoun. Mitchell, the pull-up from 17. That won't drop. Calhoun, a second chance. Rebound to Reiser.
Okay, everybody take a deep breath.
That's what Anna Owens is doing right now.
I've been quiet.
We are
for
going
like
to walk.
Yeah. You're the one doing all the hard work today, my friend.
I'll step aside. Thank you, Anna, for slowing it down.
See how Ohio State does in this man-to-man defense. What Cincinnati does with it. Going to be able to set some screens and keep it moving.
Shot clock to 5. Owens down to 1. There'll be a shot clock violation. And that will get us to a timeout with 4:44 to go in the first quarter. Oh, Jamel Elliott wore comfortable shoes for this track meet today. Back at home.
Making a difference, and Ohio State's taking some quick shots in the offense. Certainly not out of character for them. And this is what Cincinnati's going to have to dig deep into today, especially with that 36% field goal defense. And against a team like Ohio State that shoots so many threes, those mean long rebounds. So you'll get some missed shots, but the question is, will you get the ball back so you can start your offense?
Mistake coming out of the timeout as Ohio State running their offense and throwing the basketball away. And they'll get a look for Michaela Waterman into the game.
And 3 turnovers so far for Ohio State. See what they do. They've changed up their defenses quite a bit. We've seen a 3-2 zone. Now we're seeing a trap.
Knocked out of the hands of Goins. And a turnover. 4th turnover for the Bearcats.
Well, she got stuck. She picked the ball up in the 2 worst spots. You could pick it up in the corner and got trapped. Nowhere to go. And you see, it's exactly where Mitchell was trying to funnel her into. And great quick hands. That ball knocked out of bounds. Michaela Waterman.
Sophomore Antoinette Miller into the game for Cincinnati. Waterman back outside to Mitchell. Finding the range again. Made her first shot. Then missed her next 5.
When the ball gets entered into a player like Waterman, anyone, well, really for Ohio State, can shoot it. But you cannot leave Mitchell.
Thomas with the follow-up. She has 4 off the bench for Cincinnati. Waterman takes to that Thomas and scores it. Waterman, though, is hurt. And she's in a lot of pain. She came down awkwardly after scoring the basket. And right away, and we'll get an update to you as soon as we can on the status of the junior from Kettering, Ohio. Certainly, her health is the most important thing. But as far as this game is concerned, you've got Mavunga on the bench, two fouls in the opening minutes of this game, and now one of your rotational players, Waterman, to the locker room with an injury.
Your starting five makes up 86.5% of your points. So you certainly don't have a lot to spare, and the bench in a game like this, it might have to be big for Ohio State.
Rogers pass and the finish by Brianna Livingston, freshman out of Canada, getting her first 2 points. She's averaging 2 points a game. So Jamel Elliott going to her bench and getting contributions from Thomas and from Livingston here in the first quarter. Extra pass by Mitchell. Rebound for Thomas. Batted away. Good defensive play by Doss. Harper all alone. First points for Lene Harper, third on the team in scoring at better than 15 points a game. Had 16 in the win against Dartmouth. That was just two nights ago after Ohio State had a long layoff and they played the Big Green Friday night. Bus down here last night, had a practice here at St. Ursula about 7 o'clock last night. So they've been on a little bit of a whirlwind as Sam Rogers gets her second field goal.
Yeah, teams this time of year, a lot of miles, and you got to also have to think about exams right before the holiday break and the amount of stress that that alone could put on you. And then on top of that, you're a student athlete and you're traveling. Sometimes games like this before or just after the holidays, you are a mess. There's a ton of turnovers and missed shots, but not this one. Love the way these two teams prepared. They look sharp from the onset.
Sierra Calhoun. Five points for Calhoun. Another turnover for the Bearcats.
Yeah, Livingston's got to look up the floor a little more and realize she's got some options to pass over the defense. Ooh, hesitation leads to a turnover for Kelsey Mitchell.
Now we've seen Mitchell the last three trips look for assists instead of looking for her shots. Now weaving through is Calhoun. Rogers stood her ground, and it will be Ohio State basketball.
Game starting to get a bit sloppy again, turning into a trap meet. Both teams got to settle down and not just rely on speed and expect speed to score the points, because they won't.
Officials talk it over. It'll actually be Cincinnati basketball, Brooke.
So Cincinnati has to deal with this pressure of Ohio State a lot better. They've been turning the ball over, making silly passes, and getting caught up in the corner. So it's difficult because of the speed and strength. One of the better defenders in the country, Lene Harper. She makes it difficult just inbounding the ball, you know?
Goings back into the game for the Bearcats. Rogers. Back to Johnson. 90 seconds to go in our opening quarter. 2-point lead for the Bearcats. 1-point lead, I beg your pardon, for the Bearcats. Away. Doss. Two Bearcats are back. Doss can't get it to go.
A couple times the Buckeyes could have used one more dribble to get to the basket. He's trying to float there. It looks good. Doesn't count.
Johnson was fouled as she tried to give up the basketball to Reiser. It'll be a foul on Sierra Calhoun. Comes with a minute to go in our first quarter. Wednesday at 8 Eastern on ESPN and the ESPN app. The DXL Frisco Bowl. Louisiana Tech taking on SMU. SMU 7-5, their first bowl appearance in 5 years. Sonny Dykes, his SMU coaching debut. That's coming up on Wednesday.
Good defense from Ohio State. Alexa Hart doing what she does. 7 shots back. Rejection City.
Rebound ends up in the hands of Mitchell. And a second chance here for Ohio State. Saved by Doss.
Almost passed to Coach Elliott there on the sideline, who's on the floor right now. She's got to be careful.
Mitchell comes up short. Shot clock is off. Cincinnati can hold for a final. And a palming violation. Turnover, an unforced error for the Bearcats. Hey, look at the scoreboard. Cincinnati's leading by a point, but they have turned the ball over eight times in this first quarter.
Yeah, they're beating themselves, and it's the pressure of Ohio State at times. But that is so unforced. You're sitting there thinking about it, trying to look back at Coach Elliott, and you carry the ball.
Doss, wide open three, is good. Second three-pointer of the quarter for Asia Doss, and Ohio State will take the lead at the end of one quarter. But the Buckeyes have some issues. Mavunga with a couple of fouls. Waterman off. A St. Ursula alum. We know you're from Cincinnati, but
right.
This is where you've spent some time.
Yeah.
The basketball court, softball. What did I miss? What
tennis.
Else?
Tennis. Also play tennis. But this used to be a parking lot full of gravel. And I remember walking out of the doors across the street thinking, this would make for a great space for a gym.
And when I say it's the house that Weisbro built, your
literally,
actually,
he did the brickwork
here.
That's right. It is the foundation built by Weisbro. Now,
there is a joke there about Weisbro's laying bricks in this building, but I
never played here, so
you
really can't say that.
That's true.
I did plenty of that at Coastal Carolina. Don't worry. It's awesome to be back, and great to see Cincinnati embrace this gym and St. Ursula embrace Cincinnati as their temporary home, and a great showing today by the crowd to support both the Bearcats and Kelsey Mitchell, who comes right here from Cincinnati at Princeton High School.
Antoinette Miller got the first hoop of the second quarter, flipped ahead to Mavunga, who is back into the game, picked up those two early fouls. That's her first field goal.
I expect her to be a lot more dialed in here in the second quarter, even with two fouls. She and I talked pregame, and one of the things that's much different about her game this year and sharper is how much film she's watched of herself. She said, sometimes I make things way too difficult. When I watch myself on film, I say, why didn't I just step here or shoot this shot instead of taking that an extra dribble? She really has elevated that part of her game, and it shows.
Chelsea Warren into the game for Cincinnati, number 25. Five on the shot clock. Traveling violation, another turnover for the Bearcats. That's number nine. Well, one thing about Mavunga is how she's gotten into great shape for this year. She has watched her diet, she's exercised, because they're expecting her to play more minutes, and she feels great.
Good point. I mean, with the starters playing in the 30-plus minutes, Mavunga knew she was going to have to really get in shape for the season. So first thing she did was cut out red meat. And the next thing she did was cut out all the sodas, the juices. Here you call it pop, Cincinnati. Now she only drinks water, and actually Lene Harper's on that same train. You have to be in shape. And in my point of view, the less meat, the better. It'll help you out athletically.
Doss on the drive. Beautiful take to the basket by the senior from Detroit.
How smooth is she? I mean, the way that she minimizes her dribbles and maximizes the amount of steps that she can take just to get to the rim. She's so efficient. She floats. Ooh, nice move. Great finish
by Shanice Johnson. She has four. Miller all over Mitchell. Mitchell finds a way.
That's Kelsey Mitchell's competitiveness coming to life right there. As if it doesn't show up every game, every play, but something special. Try to steal the ball from her. She's going to show you the way.
7 points for Mitchell. Johnson tries it from deep. Mavunga with the rebound. Ohio State on top by four with the basketball first half. Mitchell is fouled, taking a shot, and it'll be a two free throw trip to the line for Kelsey Mitchell.
It's a good hesitation there. That's what I'm talking about, the float game. And Mitchell just driving through traffic, picking it up just like a running back. A couple of good ones that come out of her school there, of course. She just says how much she loves to compete. And you want to hear that because you want your star player to have that desire. She said, it doesn't matter what it is. It could be ping pong, grades, basketball, anything. I want to compete. And it's amazing how much your teammates can soak that up because I said, okay, well, next to you, who's the most competitive? She said, no disrespect to anybody else, but I can't tell. I said, Kelsey, that's a great thing. That means everybody's trying to get to your level.
One of two at the free throw line for Mitchell. She has eight. Doss also with eight, and the Buckeyes lead by five. Anna Owens, deep three. Lavunga has the rebound. Mitchell, pull up three. Lavunga fighting on the glass, and she was fouled. Well, it looks like a young lady who was on the bench with a couple of fouls and was just waiting for the moment to get back into the game because she's been active. Chelsea Mitchell, homecoming as well for twin sister of Kelsey. You had a chance to talk to her before the game as well.
I did. Just such a bright young lady and has such a great future ahead of her, which she's actually already getting started on. Told me she has dreams of opening a daycare center. Her and her mom invested in a building, and they're in the process of renovating it right now. I said, well, hope you understand, being an entrepreneur is like student athlete times 1,000. Be ready. She said, I think I'm ready. I've experienced a lot of life. I believe her.
Anna Owens getting her first hoop. Bringing it back to a three-point game. Last year's meeting, Cincinnati actually led 28-17 in Columbus in the second quarter as Lene Harper knocks down a triple.
Yeah, Ohio State's defense went on lockdown the last time these two teams met. Cincinnati had just 10 points in the second half.
1 point in the fourth quarter in the meeting last year between these two teams. Yeah, after that Cincinnati lead, it was 63-10 Ohio State the rest of the way. But just when you think Ohio State is thinking about a little separation in this game, Cincinnati's come back with an answer.
Yeah, how big was that shot for the Bearcats? Bring their confidence back in this game, knowing it's 40 minutes, knowing Ohio State will not stop. They're coming at you 100 miles an hour every possession.
Thomas with 7 points off the bench. Owens, two more for the Bearcats. And a timeout called by Ohio State. That gets the sold-out crowd going a little bit here in Cincinnati. 1 point game.
Getting to see him kind of go from there to Notre Dame as an assistant for Muffet McGraw, then take over the program at Xavier and really built a national reputation. Took them to the Elite Eight, in fact.
When he was the head coach at Xavier,
right,
said he and his family lived about 10 minutes or so from this building, so very familiar with this area.
Yep.
Lots of homecomings to talk about here today. First and foremost for Kelsey Mitchell, the nation's leading scorer. Her Buckeyes are now on top by three after that hoop by Mavunga.
You can see Kevin McGuff in that timeout say, we have to move the ball. Coaches can't stand when players dribble or hold the ball too much. That's a gimme. Got to put that down. That's Shanice Johnson with the miss.
Rebound for Mavunga. Mitchell. Back outside Calhoun. Lavunga kept it alive for a split second, controlled by the Bearcats. 4.5 to go here in the second quarter. Rolling to the basket is a freshman, Thomas. Boy, she has been a nice spark off the bench as she's done all season long. 9 points already in the first half, averaging nearly 12 a game. Does it in a hurry, too, against Howard the other night. Had 19 points in 21 minutes. Also 11 rebounds in those 21 minutes.
Quick work. Like that. And you like the confidence. Just come in and say, hey, just play for me. Give me some rebounds, some defense. And turns out you get 19 points.
Johnson gets it back. Will step outside for three. Thomas fighting for another rebound. And the possession arrow pointing Ohio State's way.
Let's go back to the screen. Good job by Thomas. And then the dish down inside. Great screen and roll. And not to mention taking the contact to finish the play. Love to see that out of any player, especially freshman, being able to keep the concentration alive and finish the shot.
Hart couldn't get it to go, but Johnson picked up the foul. Now send Alexa Hart, senior from Columbus, to the free throw line to shoot a couple. Three-point lead for the Buckeyes, who have won three in a row. The Bearcats have won three of their last four.
Alexa Hart, it's such a key ingredient to the success of this team. Doesn't get, obviously, the same amount of mentions as a Kelsey Mitchell. But what she contributes, her defense, her rebounding, and a lot of the X-factor, non-stat sheet kind of plays within a game, she's a difference maker. Ball handlers know. You're going into the lane, 22's in there, and you think twice before you go all the way. You might want to pull up for a short jumper.
One of two at the free throw line for Hart. Pressure in the backcourt again from Ohio State. Livingston. Hart fouled on the reach. Reiser was there to receive the pass. First team foul this quarter on the Buckeyes. 3:15 to go before halftime. Thomas. Goings open for three. She's got it.
Interesting possession for Cincinnati. You give up a good shot, end up getting a great one. Just getting ready to make a comment on Thomas to say I would love to have seen her take that shot or try to go all the way to the rim. But to my point about Alexa Hart being in the lane, she was there, and they decided to kick it out.
First points for Goings. She had missed her first five field goal attempts. Miller, the rebound. Back to Thomas. Thomas looks to take it this time and scores again into double figures for the eighth time this season. A freshman from Oakland has put the Bearcats in front by one.
Impressive. Comes in with no fear.
Off the Hart miss, the Bearcats want to run. Goings, strong take. Just would not fall for her. Kelsey Mitchell has the rebound for the Buckeyes. Mitchell crosses and is fouled on her way to the basket. She'll shoot a couple. Livingston gets called for the foul.
Let's go back to this terrific offensive possession for Cincinnati. They hold a one-point lead. They avoid the trap, the ball fake, kick out, and then you reverse sides once again when you get the traffic. And like I said, you give up a good shot for a great shot. Love the discipline on that play. So many average shots you could have rushed and taken, especially as Ohio State tried to add that pressure. Some great maturity on that play from the Bearcats.
A couple of free throws for Kelsey Mitchell. She has 12. She's one of six from outside the three-point line. However, to your original point about how she's getting her teammates involved, she has five assists here in the first half.
Yeah, she hasn't been a big presence offensively in the second quarter, and you see a lot more shots taken from her teammates. So we'll wonder when it is going to be Kelsey Mitchell to just take over.
Johnson, the feed from Reiser. Cincinnati back in front. Harper wide open for three. That won't go. Doss grabs a loose ball as Owens couldn't hold on to it.
Yeah, Owens really felt that she was about to get that board and knew it needed a little more effort.
Mitchell got it for two. 14 points for Kelsey Mitchell, averaging almost 26 a game. Reiser flying in is Lene Harper, who is always in the right spot to get a rebound. It seems shot clock is off. Ohio State will hold for a final shot. Cincinnati knows Kelsey Mitchell's going to take the final shot. Second air ball we saw this half from Mitchell.
Yeah, Kevin McGough called a play, and that's not what was executed. He wanted it done to the right side of the floor.
Good if it goes. That's a good first half for Cincinnati, even though they have trouble with turnovers. They're down by just a point here in front of a sellout crowd.
Yeah, well played first half for Cincinnati. Keeping Kelsey Mitchell to 14 points is the dribble in panic right when the second quarter starts. Certainly not the way you want to start this second half of basketball, especially the way you came out in the first quarter. So good move. Got to push that point. And she hopes her team will respond. At least they're able to break this pressure.
Ohio State aggressive on the defensive end. Rogers gets an open three, can't hit it. Offensive rebound and a foul as Reiser was hit. Foul on Lene Harper, her first. We got a report on Michaela Waterman, who was injured in the first half. It's a left ankle sprain. She will not return. First one good for Reiser. 5 points for Reiser. Only one Cincinnati player double figures. That's Thomas. Came off the bench to score 11 in the first half. Harper with their fifth rebound. And Ohio State and Cincinnati are tied for the fifth time this afternoon. Calhoun over Rogers. Yes. 4-3. Seven points for Sierra Calhoun. Going to the front court for the Bearcats as they set up down by three. Came that close to tying it. Great battle on the glass by Reiser, who has seven.
Really impressive with the way she's attacked the glass. And Cincinnati, a quick shot early in that offense after breaking the 2-2-1 press. Reiser cleaned it up. Mavunga having a tough afternoon, finding her way to the bucket. She's just 4 points, but has only taken 5 field goals. Remember, she got in that foul trouble big time in the first half.
2 of 5 shooting, picked up 2 fouls, 3 minutes and 37 seconds into the game. Reiser feeling a little confidence, but instead gets called for the travel. 10th turnover for the Bearcats. Ohio State has turned it over 4 times. Calhoun fouled by Rogers.
Sierra Calhoun came into this game shooting 56% over her last 3 games. You want to find the hot hand, and they've definitely gone to her in this game. She's 3 of 9 from 3. Excuse me, from the floor, just 1 of 5 from 3.
You were saying?
And a little head nod. Like, not only did she make that, but she walked down the floor and just shook her head a bit, said, yeah, I'm back. I'm not ready to cool off just yet.
She's the second player for Ohio State into double figures. She has 10 after knocking down that 3-pointer. And another foul call. A lot of whistles here in the opening 2 minutes of the third quarter.
Take another look at this one. Shimmy shake with the shot. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Know that feeling well.
One and done for Cincinnati on the other end, and a rebound for Sierra Calhoun.
And how nice is it for Kevin McGough to get yet another high-quality transfer, Calhoun from Duke.
Mitchell knocks down the 3.
Good set up. Asia Doss. Love the way these two work together. A couple of 5A guards having a good time.
Another timeout called by Cincinnati. Good numbers for Mitchell, and she'll put up big numbers night after night, but she is not the only piece to this Ohio State puzzle.
Yeah, I mean, Lene Harper, a transfer from Kentucky. We talked about Sierra Calhoun coming from Duke. And we see a Cincinnati turnover off the inbound. And Lene Harper at 5'8 is the best rebounding guard for her size in the country. So you get points, you get assists, rebounding, toughness and effort, and experience.
Off the Cincinnati turnover for the Bearcats, they're 11th. Ohio State with 16 points off of Bearcat turnovers, and Ohio State all over the basketball again, but a little too aggressively from Lene Harper, who's whistled for the foul.
She did a great job sticking with the play and was just trying to get rewarded for the effort. Didn't agree with the call from the officials, neither did Kevin McGuff, but great job, just the tenacity that she has to stay with the play. That's a tough pass. Make the easy play. That's what Jamel Elliott is telling Nakia Goings right now. So you're an upperclassman. You got to make good decisions. Look at what's in front of you, what's available.
Goings will come out of the game. Sam Rogers will check in for the Bearcats. Get the feeling the game on the line right now for Cincinnati. They've hung tough all game long, but Ohio State coming out of the locker room a little fired up. Stretching the lead to 7, their largest of the game, and Calhoun inside. Can't get the scoop to go, batted out of bounds by Cincinnati. Last touch by Reiser. Ohio State basketball. Doss on the run, and a rebound for Rogers. Cincinnati gets a stop, and they get a run out.
You had to throw that perfectly. Some Tom Brady-ness to it. Well, wait a minute, Cincinnati. Danny Dalton, see, there's still a QB here, right?
It's a little touchy subject right now,
yeah,
around here.
I'm sure.
The local NFL team. Inside a 7 to play in the third quarter. Big hoop for Reiser and Cincinnati to stop the Ohio State run. Last touch by the Bearcats. Buckeyes basketball.
Let's go back and take another look at that.
The feed by Owens.
Yeah, just beautifully fed off the good defense and the rebound from Rogers. Wow. Beautifully placed. Good concentration from Reiser, who has just impressed me on each possession in this game. A lot of toughness. He had a big, big responsibility being on the inside.
Off the Mitchell miss. Owens into the front court.
Yes.
Reiser.
Exactly. Great move. Way to move without the basketball. Tugged on her jersey. Said, Coach, you got to give me a break here. I need some time.
Reiser with 11. 7 since halftime. Mavunga gets her first points of the second half. She has 6. Reiser has scored all 7 Cincinnati points in the second half, and Thomas will have a chance at the free throw line. She's fouled.
Good take from Thomas. The miss here. And we'll watch Mavunga go back up for the offensive rebound. That's a very high skill set she has with offensive rebounding. She reads the ball so well coming off the rim. And you see 5 of them a game to lead the Big Ten. The length. Now, with the nutrition that's been added to her diet and taking out all the bad stuff, putting in all the good stuff, it really certainly helps her game. And what a game she had against Stanford. Those 26 rebounds. It's incredible.
That was an Ohio State record. 7 double-doubles this year, 45 in her career. 5-point game. Ohio State with the lead and the basketball. Mitchell. Foul before the shot. Livingston gets whistled for the Cincinnati foul. Tuesday, we'll have the Cherubundi Tart Cherry Boca Raton Bowl at 7 Eastern on ESPN and the ESPN app. Lane Kiffin and his FAU team at high-powered offense against the Zips of Akron, FAU 10-3 on the season. Ohio State scores again. Their largest lead of the game. They're on top by 8.
Yeah, Mitchell with that 3. Cincinnati cannot sleep. You can't give her a space. Can't give her a step. Not an inch.
20 for Kelsey Mitchell. And she's got the ball again. 3-on-2 the other way. Doss. That won't go down for Mavunga, but she'll have a chance at the free throw line. Seems like Ohio State was searching for a little bit quicker gear in that first half. Never found it, but they found it here in the third quarter, it seems.
Yeah, and even though Mitchell is their leader, it almost at times feels like she's allowing the space for someone else to step up and take over in this game. And Mavunga fighting through the frustrations of foul issues and not finishing on those short shots. And that's where Sierra Calhoun has picked the team up with her three-point shooting. Kevin McGuff having many options in the starting lineup as scorers. One of the deficits on this team is their bench. He just doesn't have a lot to go to. A lot is expected of those starters in their minutes.
And down one bench player, Waterman, who averages 19 minutes a game, traveling, called on Johnson, out with an ankle injury.
And if she can make the move and use a Euro step and swing that ball over and around the defense, be fighting the traffic so much.
Turnovers continue to pile up for the Bearcats. Ohio State a plus 9 in turnover margin. Calhoun. Grabbed by Goings. Goings has been quiet today. 1 of 7 shooting. 3 points. Came in as the top scorer for Cincinnati at 12 and a half a game. Goings. Johnson. Johnson. Looked like she was trying to drop down the pass, and Mavunga got called for a third personal foul.
I'm not sure I agree with this one. Kevin McGuff pleading his case, saying that's not even close. Take another look to see. No foul on the way up. And from here, that looked 100% basketball. Mavunga can't believe it.
Johnson makes the first free throw, so Mavunga to the bench with her third personal foul. Fourth personal foul on Mavunga. That's 4 on Mavunga.
Pressure of their own. See if they might be able to get a trap and force Ohio State into some turnovers. They've had just 4 this afternoon. Excellent management of the basketball.
And they Harper on the offensive glass. Looking to get some contact. Puts it up with the right hand for 2.
That's 5'8 going to work. And 6-foot Johnson.
Goings had an open look. Gets the offensive rebound. A second chance here for the Bearcats. Down by 10. Hart, the rebound. Mitchell wants to run. Mitchell on the dribble. On the drive. Can't get it to go, but she'll earn a trip to the free throw line.
Do you feel that Ohio State is itching to break this game open? They want to get the pace back up with the basketball. You know, the Mitchell family is just waiting for something to happen. She just messes with defenders and somehow still finds a way to get a clean shot off. That's what I don't understand about Kelsey Mitchell. She doesn't jump out of the gym. Her speed is definitely next level, but it's the way that she uses the speed. It's not just, let me go 100 miles an hour. It's lateral quickness and the pace. She's so confusing to defenders. You literally never know which way she's going to go. She just makes life difficult.
Makes them both. 22 points for Mitchell. Her season high 37 came against Stanford. Went for 22 last time out against Arvin. And Mitchell gets called for the foul. That'll be the first team foul. Second team foul on the Buckeyes. Goings go to the free throw line to shoot a couple. 3:29 to go in the third. Been a struggle for the junior from Georgia. 1 of 8 from the field, 4 turnovers. Coming off a career best 25 last time out. Mitchell on the push. Mitchell has it blocked. Clean block for Cincinnati's Livingston.
Good job to stay with the play.
Calhoun for three. Running back the other way. Reiser counting in the foul. Angel Reiser getting it done for Cincinnati, keeping the Bearcats in it.
Just a few minutes ago, she had tugged on her jersey and asked for Coach Elliott to give her a sub. Oh, was really able to get recharged in those minutes, and I am so impressed with the way that she's run the floor this afternoon. Her competitiveness doesn't take the hand of Alexa Hart to get back up.
Going to be a lane violation on Cincinnati as Livingston stepped in. She'll head to the bench with Owens back into the game. Now, Jamel Elliott knew that Cincinnati was going to have to play mistake-free basketball for 40 minutes today, but they have hurt themselves some unforced errors. We saw one there. We saw some unforced turnovers. Just some mistakes being made by the Bearcats, and now it's a 14-point lead for the Buckeyes.
And those possessions that were turnovers, if you think if they just had a chance to turn some of those into shot attempts, where could this game be?
Thomas, her first points of the second half and 11 in the first half.
No, Elliott needs to be careful that she doesn't get a technical foul. You know, they extended the coach's box this year 38 feet, but not 38 feet onto the court. Her assistants have had to pull her back off a couple times. Jamel Elliott has been very demonstrative this game, knowing how close it is. And doesn't want to see this get out of hand. She knows it's been competitive and just wants to keep her players on a high level. See what they can do. Perhaps one, maybe two more runs.
Lene Harper with the turnover. Johnson.
Nice ball fake.
To get around Hart for two. Mitchell. Harper had it for the moment. That's going to be another traveling violation called on Cincinnati. Turnover number 15 for the Bearcats. Now the Buckeyes will settle things down with 2 minutes to go in the third quarter. It was a one-point game at halftime. Ohio State has outscored Cincinnati 24-15 this quarter. Hart can't add to it. And out of reach. Another Cincinnati turnover.
And two more possessions that could have been at least shot attempts. So when you go back to the film and you watch this one, you say, hey, if we lose this game, let's look at why. And a lot of times it's plays like that when you beat themselves.
Hart's pass, thrown away.
Tough shot. Goings.
Goings in Cincinnati getting some points off an Ohio State turnover. Outside, Calhoun answers with a three for the Buckeyes.
Who's got the answer for Calhoun? Ohio State has found number four in the second half, as she has delivered, coming in hot into this game, shooting 56% over the last three. She's found the rhythm.
Calhoun with 18 points, 14 coming here in the third quarter. She had a season-high 20 against Dartmouth last time out, so Sierra Calhoun staying hot and helping Ohio State to an 11-point lead. Monday Night Football coming up. Oh, it's a big one with Matt Ryan, Julio Jones, and the Falcons, who are 8-5, traveling to Tampa Bay to take on Jameis Winston and the Bucks. Monday Night Countdown kicks off our coverage at 6 p.m. Eastern from Raymond James Stadium in Tampa. Last time Atlanta took on Tampa Bay, Jones had 12 catches, 253 yards.
Oh,
so it's
all
a favorable matchup.
Got it. Is Jameis Winston going to eat another W? That's his specialty now, right? He's a character, that's for sure. He's like that his game backs up his mouth. That's all that matters.
That's the challenge. You're going to eat those W's, you have to be able to go out and do it. Speaking of which, here's Kelsey Mitchell. 24 for Mitchell. That ball was looked like it was tipped out of bounds. Officials say it'll be Ohio State basketball.
Well, Thomas looked very out of sync handling the basketball. You don't give a big the basketball, just over half court. She wasn't in good position to make the right decision with it. So I put that turnover on the guards as much as I do Thomas.
About 3 seconds between the shot clock and the game clock, so Mitchell will hold for a final shot. 10 points in the quarter for Kelsey Mitchell. For two. Got it. 26 for Mitchell. Goings at the buzzer is short, and that is the end of the third quarter. A strong third quarter for the nation's 13th ranked team. They put 31 points on the board in the quarter, 12 of those.
And Courtney Carey on the right. We were joking around
for you
about this gym. You know, we played everywhere my senior year. We didn't have a home place to play. I said, if we had this gym, we would have won state. No problem. There were three of us within the league. We all transferred here to St. Ursula. Caused a lot of commotion, but ended up for the best.
Good defensive play by Angel Reiser for Cincinnati, and a foul called on Hart. Bearcats start this quarter down by 13 after Ohio State outscored them 31-19 in the third quarter. Reiser's pass intended for Johnson. Turnover number 18 for the Bearcats. Just 6 turnovers for Ohio State here this afternoon. Kelsey Mitchell with 26 points, 9 of 22 from the field. Also has 8 assists.
Kevin McGuff instructing his players he had a play to run, and Kelsey Mitchell saw a wide open three. She said, you know what, I have one of those plays too. I'm going to run that one.
Even Kevin would tell you that's play number one in the book. ...16-point lead for Ohio State. They're on top by one at halftime. ...29 points for Kelsey Mitchell. Here's Calhoun. Hart. Harper on the offensive glass. Harper still fighting and getting rewarded.
Are you kidding me? She is so strong. Tenacious. Look at her cleaning up, just trying to cause havoc.
Going, spinning, and scoring.
Okay. Love that move over a terrific defender, Lexa Hart. How she avoided the block there. And Cincinnati's got to find some next level of energy. Try to climb back into this game. Now's the time. And Ohio State will put your physical abilities to the test. We've seen a few players tonight, including number 4, Angel Reiser, call for a breather.
Doss can't get the three. The rebound to Imari Thomas. Reiser. Calhoun rips down the rebound. Ohio State looking to run the other way. Calhoun. Another rebound for Thomas.
A lot of contact on that play. Calhoun able to play through it, get the shot off. Didn't look for a call afterwards, just kept on playing, and Reiser with the step back jump shot.
There's a player playing with a ton of confidence now, 1 point shy of her career and season high. Last year as a freshman, started just 3 games, played 14 minutes a game, averaged 4 points a game. She has made a big leap for Cincinnati here in the first half of her sophomore year. Harper to the basket. Rogers with the rebound, and Cincinnati back the other way, inside of 7 to play in the fourth quarter here in Cincinnati. for Calhoun. Calhoun all the way for two more. 20 points now for Sierra Calhoun. Back-to-back games with 20.
Wow, same play, and you see the strength. She and Sam Rogers were going step for step, and as soon as they met, boom, Rogers went flying.
Goings can't get the three. Doss tipped it into the hands of Kelsey Mitchell.
You get a bit of sense that Cincinnati is slowly running out of steam here in this fourth quarter.
Harper got the rebound and was fouled. Jetson Coretti into the game for Ohio State. Stephanie Mavunga back in as well. She picked up her fourth foul with 5:16 to go in the third quarter. They look for Mavunga right away on the baseline, out of bounds play.
Yeah, just miscommunication there. Should have been guarding Mitchell and blocking off that lane access to Mavunga.
Livingston. Chelsea Warren has checked in for Cincinnati. Three-pointer won't stay down for Miller. Put back from Livingston is no good, but she has a rebound, and Cincinnati has a second chance. Five and a half to go in the fourth. 18-point lead for the Buckeyes. Maya Benham into the game. Shot clock at five. Pull up is no good. Mitchell rips away the rebound. Coretti on the run. Harper, another offensive rebound and a putback for Lene Harper. Into double figures with 11 points. She has 12 rebounds for the Buckeyes as well. The shot hit the shot clock, so it will be Ohio State basketball when we come back. Buckeyes pulling away, 13th ranked team in the country, on top by 20 in the fourth. Her daughter's on the court at the same time right now.
Yeah, this is a pretty special moment. You know, and I asked Mark, I said, what do you remember about your daughters playing in this gym? He said it was pretty special. Chelsea had 20, Kelsey had 35. And Cheryl texted him and she said, hey, you're missing all the fireworks here. He was down the street coaching his high school team at Taft. Said I was late to the game and I shouldn't have been.
Kelsey Mitchell with 29 points. Came in averaging 25.8 points per game. And you can see she's flirting with the triple-double. 4:25 to go here in the fourth. Livingston shut off and a rebound for Chelsea Mitchell. Sisters having a little conversation.
You know, it was Chelsea that actually committed here first. I should say here, but to Ohio State. And said, guys, let's see what's possible with the Buckeyes. So she was the one. She said, let's go.
Johnson hits a three. Shanice Johnson into double figures with 11 points. Reiser leading the way for Cincinnati with 15. Amari Thomas with 13. Chelsea Mitchell to Harper. 3:45 to go in the fourth. Coretti. Last touched by Cincinnati's Johnson. It will be Ohio State ball with 10 to shoot. Chelsea Mitchell tried to feed it into Harper, taken away by Johnson. Owens tries the three. Harper picks it up. Harper to the basket for two more. Another outstanding game for Harper. 13 points, three rebounds.
Ohio State still with the bulk of their starters in, with Mavunga, Harper, and Mitchell out on the floor. We talked about the amount of minutes that they play. So even with the game out of hand, Well, Kevin McGough wants to make sure his starters and his top starters are in that shape come later on in the season.
Johnson, it's another three.
Line drive three from Johnson. My thoughts of taking it to the rim. Said, why not? I'm going to take this three.
Foul's going to get called on Mavunga, and she's fouled out. Nine points, six rebounds for Stephanie Mavunga. Picked up those two quick fouls in the first quarter.
Yeah, Mavunga having a frustrating afternoon. Capped off by getting fouled out. Yeah. Another day for her. Certainly she's got the stamina to lead this team to a Final Four. You have to learn how to play a little better without foul trouble. Defense, something that Ohio State as a team needs to work on. Matter of fact, Kelsey Mitchell said, we're quite lazy on defense, actually. Surprised me. She said, we're great on offense, outscore some teams, but at times we can get lazy. Said.
Just in that sequence there, Brooke, Mitchell was really trying to D up on Johnson. Got called for the hand check.
Right.
Got called for the foul, but at least trying to back up what she told you, trying not to be lazy on D with the game in hand, although Cincinnati trying to cut into the deficit as Miller takes it to the basket and was fouled. Peretti picks up the foul.
And there's certain ways that you could categorize what is lazy. Lazy is not trying, right? But it's certainly trying, but the position is not there. So you have to learn the proper position, the lateral footwork, the defending without fouling and being handsy. That's lazy defense. Not that you're not trying, but you have to apply those skills and keep them up at a high level. Want to get to the Final Four, you got to play defense. It's that simple.
Mitchell is fouled by Miller. .208 to go. Shanice Johnson comes out for Cincinnati. Strong game for Johnson. 17 points on 6 of 11 shooting. Harper to Hart for two. Michaela Porter, freshman number 10, into the game for Cincinnati. 1:45 to go, and Goings is into double figures, knocking down that three. 11 points for Goings. Mitchell, three more. It's a two. Correction, two for Mitchell. Official says toe on the line, but that puts her over the 30-point mark. 31 points now for Kelsey Mitchell, and she's leaving the game.
What an afternoon for Kelsey Mitchell and for these fans to be able to see her once again in the 30-point range. They saw it a lot when she was a high school player. And probably her last time she'll be in the Cincinnati area, certainly this close. Her dad having coached at Taft High School just down the street. A lot of good memories of Kelsey Mitchell playing in this gym.
Foul called on Chelsea Mitchell. With 1:15 to go in the fourth. Tonight, Midnight Eastern Sports Center with Scott Van Pelt will be a big show. It'll tell you about the AFC playoff picture in the wake of the Steelers-Patriots showdown in Pittsburgh. Plus, how did the Eagles respond without Carson Wentz? Are they still Super Bowl contenders? And you'll hear from Aaron Rodgers after his return today. Cap off your weekend with Sports Center and SVP on ESPN and the ESPN app. Well, I did some math, and whenever I use that phrase, my teachers back home start to get a little nervous. But Kelsey Plum, of course, finished up with 3,527 points. At her current scoring average, Kelsey Mitchell would need 26 games, including today, to catch Plum. So that means if they make the Big Ten championship and make the Final Four, that's 26 games.
I'd say that's
so
a good goal to have.
Telling you there's a chance here.
Right.
But as we've seen today with Harper, it wasn't Mavunga's best day because of the foul trouble. Sierra Calhoun, Asia Doss, she doesn't have to go it alone. And maybe it's for the best for Ohio State if those supporting players can take on starring roles as well if they want to be in the Final Four in Columbus.
Yeah, I'd say defense, depth, and certainly having some scorers besides Mitchell, which they have now. Staying in that discipline mode, that's going to be all on Kelsey Mitchell to keep her teammates competing at that high level, not offensively, but on the defensive end. See, Lene Harper with another good take to the basket. I mean, she's right. I told you she was strong. She gave the Bearcat a little something. He's trying to moon her right now. That's something new I've never seen.
Now, the Bearcat's about 6'8", and Lene is 5'8". But everything they say about Lene Harper, that she plays bigger than that 5'8", is true when you see her in person. Another double-double for Lene Harper. 14 points, 13 rebounds. Her fifth double-double this season, 15th of her career.
She is a triple-double in the making. Oh! Ohio State, so impressive. They've got the athletic ability that is elite. They certainly have the players. They've got the transfers in. So this is the year for Kevin McGough.
Thomas backs in on Hart for two more. 15 points for the freshman. Next up for Cincinnati, they'll host Bowling Green on Thursday. Then they have their American opener at East Carolina on December 30th. It's in the Big Ten play. Next up for Ohio State, they'll be at Nebraska on the 28th of December. And their Big Ten home opener is New Year's Eve on ESPN2. Chelsea Mitchell trying to get on the scoreboard as the clock winds down and expires, and that will do it. Ohio State comes to Cincinnati and picks up an 87-76 victory. Kelsey Mitchell.